Hi guys, so this is our last video in the, this is the last and the ninth video in the placement interview preparation series, PIPs, and this final video is going to be about 10 tips and tricks that are going to get you across, and not only going to get you across, but going to help you be in the top 1% performance, okay? So let's start with the video, but before starting, a little bit about PrepLeaf. So we offer free aptitude practice on our placement preparation portal, and then placement preparation in the form of subscription-based courses that are very highly mentor-driven, so that whenever you get stuck, there will be a mentor to help you. These can be for analytics, finance, quant coding, etc. And other than that, we also have a postpaid program in which you can pay after you get a job. So all the goodness of the prepaid program, but with the option of paying later. So that is about PrepLeaf. And let's start with our first tip and trick. And that would be three key takeaways. And what I want to tell you here is that whenever you communicate, and this is more about communication rather than interviews, that whenever you communicate with someone, you should always have in mind, what is the point that I'm trying to get across? What is the entire point of this whole interview that I am giving? I want him to know these three things about me, and necessarily these three things. Even if he doesn't know anything about me other than this, it should be fine. But these three things he has to know, because they are kind of the prime of my life. They are the best things that I've ever done. So there should be three takeaways like this in every interview that you sit for. It can depend on the role. It can depend on the company. It can change from the from company to company, from role to role. But there should be three key takeaways from every interview that you want the interviewer to know. And you should always make sure that some or the other way in all your questions, these three key takeaways are covered. Why only three? Because generally a person is, it's harder to remember more than this, and lesser than this, you will be at a disadvantage. So two is too little, four is too more. Okay. So three key takeaways from the entire interview. Be clear about what you want to communicate. Revolve around that every answer of yours. Okay. Second key takeaway, there should always be an elevator pitch. You can go back to our first video and you can see what an elevator pitch is. And in that I mentioned that why an elevator pitch is important. And of all the things that you can mention in the elevator pitch, of the 5-6 things that I mentioned in the first video, the top three, that is your the top three are your education, your experience, and your positions of responsibility or volunteer work. So all that should always be there in your interview. Your elevator pitch should be ready. It should be learned by heart, and you can even say it while you are asleep. Like if somebody wakes you up in the middle of night, you should have it by heart and you should just say it. While the interviews are going on, your elevator pitch should be your go-to strategy, so that even if you get a walk-in interview and you know nothing about the firm, at least this one is figured out, okay? So always prepare your elevator pitch, not just for the interviews, but for your life. It is gonna really help you even strike informal conversations with professional people when you meet them in corporate setting, okay? So always have that elevator pitch ready with you. Use stories. In the last interview, I remember, in the last video, if you remember, I vividly told you why stories are important. As I told you that stories are 22 times more memorable than a fact. So always tell stories in your interview so that the person remembers you, so that whatever you are saying is not only remembered, but also remembered with the person who's saying it, that is you. So tell your stories, and always tell your stories around the soft skills, the growth, the experience that you had from it, or the experience of working somewhere, and the learning that you got from the incident, okay? So always focus every answer on your story. And remember, I told you in the last video that every answer that you're gonna say can be narrated in the form of stories. So always have your stories handy, always have your stories ready with yourself, and go back, sit down with yourself, you know, order a cup of coffee and just think what happened in these last 4 years, and what all stories, what all incidents can you recall? And these will fill up your interview. Whenever you try to recall all the highlights of your 4 years, your past 4 years or 2 years, they're gonna fill up these gaps. They're gonna fill up the stories that you want to tell in the interview. So always tell your answer in the form of stories. Then my fourth point would be rule of three. So this rule of three is very different from the three takeaways. Three takeaways are kind of like the summary of your interview. the summary of the entire interview. But the rule of three says that whenever you are asked something, and if you have to say it in multiple points, multiple bullet points, there should always be 3 points. Not two, not four, just three. Two is too little, four is too much. And that is something that I sincerely tell my students in the PrepLeaf placement preparation program for data analytics course that I take, that whenever you are writing your resume, whenever you are practicing interview with me, give me 3 points. Give me 3 impact-driven, accomplishment-driven points that tell me what are you trying to say. They should not be more, they should not be less, okay? Because 3 is kind of the magic number that you can remember. 2 will keep you at a disadvantage. 4th point, he will never remember. So 3 is the sweet spot where you can meet the interviewer and you can make them remember it if you say it correctly. So if you are to answer something in multiple points, which I prefer not, because generally 3-point answers are like 60-second answers, but I prefer 30-second answers, and you should also prefer 30-second answers. So in that case, just if it comes to that, use 3, otherwise just finish it in 30 seconds, okay? The 5th point, do not oversell yourself. I understand that this process of interview is scary. It is scary to everyone. Our co-founders, when they sat for their job, they had it. I had it. Everyone has it. Everyone is scared of the interview process. And yes, scaredness comes from insecurity, that will I make it, will I not make it? And when you're insecure, you tend to oversell yourself. That's a natural instinct. When you're insecure, you'll just explain yourself more. You'll just try to tell the other person that, okay, don't reject me, I'm just worthy enough. Maybe I'm not able to explain it, so can I explain it this much more? Can I explain it this much more? What you tend to do is, you tend to sell yourself. You tend to tell that, okay, not only I have this, but I also have this. I also have this and also this. But the point is that you don't have to do that. You can just say it in one line and satisfy yourself that if he is to select me, he will select me in that. If not, it will never happen. I have also told you in the past that interviews and jobs are like marriages. You will only find a good, you will only make it if you are a good match. Otherwise, you will fail it. Either, even if they hire you, they'll fire you. So the point is that do not oversell yourself. If it has to happen, it will just happen in a 30-second answer. You don't have to extend it to 2 minutes and just keep selling yourself, okay? So don't oversell yourself. 6th point, take time but don't. So what I want to say here is that take your time. If you can't think of something, if you can't think of something, then don't just keep blabbering on. That's never a good strategy. Take a pause, ask for 2 minutes, and then say a very succinct, concise, and precise answer. Otherwise, what will happen is you will take 2.5 minutes of blabbering to say nothing. Or you can take 2 minutes to think and you can take a 30-second answer that he will remember. Those two situations are very different. The 2.5 minutes of blabbering will immediately make him throw you out. The interviewer will throw you out of the room. Or in the case when you take a pause and say, it seems like the person is thoughtful and he thinks before he speaks. And that's a very good quality that you articulate your messages very well. Your communication is very effective. And that's a very good strategy to have. So ask for 2 minutes, but don't take longer than 30 seconds while answering, okay? That's my 6th point for you. Let's go to the 7th point. Order is important. So I once read an experiment in social psychology in which the experiment was on order. There were 2 groups of people and both were given some qualities about a random person. And then they were asked to define the person, what they think of them. And these qualities, they were both good and bad. In one group, they wrote the good qualities first and then the bad qualities. And the other group, they wrote the bad qualities first and the good qualities. The group which had whatever quality first, like in group one, there were good qualities first. So the impression of that person whose qualities were being described was taken as good. Whereas in the second group, it was taken as bad because the bad qualities were mentioned first. There are 2 reasons for it. A, you read left to right and you tend to recall that what you read first. By the end of this sentence, your grasping power dies. So whatever you heard first is your single source of truth. So whatever you want to say, if it is something important, say it in the very beginning of the interview. And that goes always with any kind of interview. Even if you appear for, let's just say, an accelerator program someday, and you know you are seeking some funding from an investor, say what you want, the impact driven points that you want, the three takeaways, say them the first thing. Do not bring them later. And even in those 3 points, whatever is the most important should come first, and then the second, and then the third. For example, if there is a question on skills, what skills do you know? So I will say my top 3 skills for an analytics role are Python, SQL and Excel, or SAS maybe. So whatever skills I want to say first. So if I want them to know it's a Python driven job, it's like more Python heavy job, so I will say Python first. If it's a more SAS heavy job, then I will say SQL first. So that totally depends on the job description, and that totally depends on what you want to convey. But whatever you want them to deem the most important, or whatever you feel is the most important, should come first. And that's necessarily a rule for you, okay? And that's your 7th rule, okay? Say positives the first, and the best the first. Okay, your 8th point would be mirror practice. Now I really want to tell you that interviews can be very scary. They can be very terrifying, very frightening, very daunting. What you essentially want, because the thing is that you're already insecure about getting a job, and the thing is that this insecurity comes from within, and when you have to look the other person in the eye, it can be really scary. You know, it can be soul emptying. It can be they directly look into your soul, and before they look into your soul, I think what is really necessary is that you have a one-on-one with yourself. Are you true to yourself? Whatever you are saying, can you at least convince your own self that these answers are correct, even if they are white lies? You have to first convince yourself, and that only comes with mirror practice. Whenever I want to do pitches, I want to do presentations, I write a basic write-up, and then I go in front of a mirror, I shit my pants while seeing myself, and then I say it out loud. It's very important that you do that, because that almost eradicates all the fear of saying it out loud. Jitna bhi mic ka confidence hota, jitna bhi practical confidence hota, that all goes with this mirror practice. And all the actors in the industry do it. They always do it in terms of the mirror practice. So that was your 8th point. Your 9th point would be learn quotes. Quotes are something that tell about the diversity of your education, about how diverse your background is. You know different fields, you have read autobiographies, you are interested in the great minds, in the greatness of the human mind, and that intel tells about the horizons to which you have expanded, and that's very important. So always say quotes in your interview, and whenever you say a quote, it's important to know about the person who you are quoting, and it's important that you never change the quote. Quotes are always said as it is, because they are in double inverted commas, and whatever is it in double inverted commas is always said as it is. So don't change your quotes, and always know about the person who you are talking, because your interviewer also might know about that person, so you may strike a good conversation. That brings me to my last point, some gray areas. Your interviewer might put you in some very tough spots. They might give you questions that might be very difficult to answer. For example, a client is asking you to lie. Will you lie for the client? The answer cannot be no, because you know the client is asking, so the client is always right. And you cannot also lie, because you also represent an organization that you are working for. So what will you do? So the best way is diplomacy. The best way is that you just dodge the question altogether. And that is what a gray area is. You just don't go into black and white. You just venture into the gray zone and dodge the question altogether. Do not get bogged down by what the interviewer is doing to you, but believe in yourself. Understand that you can stand it, understand that you have prepared for it, and just venture into the gray zone and do not nod yes or no. Okay, that's my last point for you. Here I would like to end the series and the video, but before we do, as always, I would like to mention these resources that we have on our YouTube page. These are some of the free webinars that we have held in the past, and they will really help you prepare for placements. Please check out these videos. At Preply, we just want one thing, for you to get a job. Please go and check out these. They will really help you. In the end, if you like our video, please consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. I'll be happy to answer your questions in the comment section. Thank you.